no better, Pastor. But there's another 80. There's not only a basement, there's not only acceptance, but there's abundance. Because the King says this in here, all those things that were lost, he says, you're going to get it back. You're going to get it back and more. You're going to have abundance.
All right.
Hallelujah.
Because you're part of my kingdom, and I have something in store for you.
Amen.
There you go.
You know, there was a young man that had worked all his life. You know what his dream was? His dream was to just go on a cruise. He had never been on one before. Heard a couple of things about it, but he had never been on one before.
All
and
right.
So here, he worked for a number of years until he earned enough money.
All right.
To get a cruise, to buy a ticket.
All right.
He went up to the ticket agent, and he bought him a ticket on a cruise. But before he left the house, see, he didn't know, there are certain things he didn't know, so he left his house. He packed him some peanut butter and some bread, and he took it with him because he wanted to have some food to eat while he was on this cruise. Meanwhile, he gets on this cruise ship, and there's food everywhere.
Yeah.
And people are just, I mean, they're eating like you wouldn't believe it.
Yeah.
They're walking by his room with large trays of food. Meanwhile, he would stay in his room, in his cabin, and he would eat his peanut butter sandwiches, and then he would go out. And after a while, day one went by, and day two went by, and meanwhile, the people are just eating and having a great time all around him, and he would just go out and check things out, and eat his peanut butter sandwich, and then just kind of hide out in his room. And then one day, one of the men that worked there saw him and said, "What are you doing eating a peanut butter sandwich?" He said, "Well, I knew that I had enough money to come on this cruise, but I didn't have enough money to pay for the food." And the man said, "Don't you know that when you buy a ticket on a cruise, you get the food and everything?"
All right.
You know what?
Remember.
But you know what? There's some people, God, that's the same way. Here they are. They are children of the King. But they're living on peanut butter.
Yeah.
They're living on handouts. You're missing out.
Right.
There's a lot of things I got for you.
Yes.
I got a kingdom for you. I have blessings for you. But you're hiding.
Yeah, come on. Come on. My.
That's the amazing grace of God.
Yes, sir.
That's God's grace.
Yes,
how amazing it is. No wonder when John Newton wrote that song, when he would pen the words, "Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see." Oh, there's something that is amazing about God's grace. I'm talking about a God who looks beyond our faults and he sees our needs. I'm talking about a God who's able to forgive. A God who's rich.
Yeah! Hallelujah! Come on!
Can go out and find him a fellowship.
All right.
And bring him into the palace.
All right. Amen.
Oh, but can you imagine though? Mephibosheth, he's in his shack. But over here in the palace, you got the king eating duck, living on in king-size beds with six sheets and all of the grand door. The king said, "This is what I want you to be a part of, Mephibosheth."
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Yes, yeah. Amen.
I want you to have all of that.
All of that.
Yes, sir.
But it all starts out.
It all belongs to us. Hallelujah.
By God's grace.
Yes, sir.
Someone is your kindness to me.
All right.
You know, God is still got his search.
Yes, sir.
He's in his search team out already.
Yes, sir.
Throughout the earth. God is looking for people to show kindness to.
All right. Sir.
He's already showed us kindness, but he wants to show us more kindness.
Oh, thank you.
But yet some people rather hide off. That's why Jesus said that the water that I'll give you, it'll be inside of you. And it'll cause you to never thirst again.
Amen.
Lord, if our Jesus Christ, the living water, the living bread, it'll cause us to never thirst again, never hunger again. And that's what he offers us through his grace. Hallelujah. Abasement. Acceptance. Abundance.
All right.
For the Lord is for the Mephibosheths.
Yes, sir.
There you go.
Yes, sir.
I'm talking about those people that's crippled.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
They can't walk in God's commandments.
Yes.
But he says, by grace, come on.
Come on. Yeah, come on.
You're part of my, I want you to be part of my kingdom, part of my family.
Right.
Come on.
All right.
You said, but I haven't been living right.
My Lord.
Come on. I'm lame in both legs. He said, come on.
Yeah.
I don't know about you. I don't know about you, but I appreciate God's grace.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Jesus.
That he has extended to us.
Yes. All right.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I wonder if someone here. I wonder if there's someone here who can see what this preacher is talking about. You know, as I close, what happened in Mephibosheth really was the same thing that the enemy does today.
All right.
He wants to worm his way into our hearts.
Yes, sir.
And then cause us to believe a lie.
All right. Yes.
See, the problem is that we sometimes think that God is out to harm us.
All right.
When God is really out to bless us.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He loves us so much that he wants to bless us. But you know what the enemy will tell you? He'll tell you that if you go to God, that he's out to get you.
Right.
That God is some mean, holy being. But he's not.
Come on.
He wants to show us kindness,
yes, sir,
grace, and love.
Yes, sir.
And that's what it's all about. That's why he says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest.
Amen.
Amen. I want you to just bow your heads with me just for a moment. I'm going to say a prayer, then we'll turn it over to the pastor. But God, right now, there may be someone. There may be a Mephibosheth in here somewhere. Someone that's living off in Lodibar. Living off in the place of barrenness. Hiding. Dodging. Trying to avoid you. But there's no place that we can go, oh God, that your presence is not there. And Lord, the grace, the abundance of heaven, and all the great things that you have in store for us, help us, Lord, to follow you and receive everything that you have in store for us. Let us never settle for being spiritual paupers, but help us to know and realize that we're children of the King.
Yes, sir.
And that we're rich in Jesus Christ. And everything that you have, we have. Because we are in Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm going to turn it right over to the pastor. And Pastor, thank you for this opportunity. I hope I did justice tonight. But thank you so much, Pastor.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.